guys, hope you're all having a great day. I've taken a bit of a break from the beauty side of things on my channel. I have been doing just other bits and pieces that I enjoy, but I thought it was time for a little dose of makeup. Let's start with primer. I have a few different ones here, actually. I have this one from By Terry, which is an expensive brand. It's, I don't really know what it actually is. It says Brightening CC Serum. It says Hydration Radiance Color Correction. But then I was wondering if it was a primer or if it is a color corrector. And if it's a color corrector, do you put it on before your foundation to color correct and then apply your foundation? But reading the instructions confused me even more. So it says apply in the morning on the entire face, alone or after foundation, for a smooth and intensely brightening skin. Wait, that doesn't sound right. It sounds like broken English. For a smoothed and intensely brightening skin. For a smoothed and intensely brightened skin? Bright skin? For a smooth and intensely... It should be for smooth and intensely brightened skin. That just doesn't even make sense in any way. But anyway, the bit that initially confused me before I read that was apply in the morning on the entire face, alone or after foundation. How do you apply a liquid after you apply foundation? Would you just be wiping everything? I don't understand how that works. And this one is in the shade Apricot Glow. So it must have some kind of pigment to it. Well, obviously it does, it's a color corrector. Oh, okay. And it says the same thing on the back of the bottle, for a smooth and intensely brightening skin. That sounds like the instructions on one of those weird products that I buy off eBay. It looks like it's kind of just like an illuminating primer. So I'm just rubbing it in. So it definitely does rub away pretty much nothing. There's just a slight like yellowy tinge to my skin. I also have the Huda Beauty Complexion Perfection Pre-Makeup Base. Apply dime size amount to the face using fingers or a dense brush. Can be used alone or as a pre-makeup base for a hydrating and skin smoothing effect. I only have one foundation to try today, so let's apply a different primer to each side. So this is the Huda Beauty one. Let's see if it smells like old rich people. This is the Huda one on my right side. It does have a fragrance, but it's not as strong as the other ones. I'm liking how this feels. It's like greasy but not sticky and oily. It's got like a thickness to it that kind of like adds like a bit of a slip to the skin, so when you apply it, it just glides over and you can see that my skin still looks a little bit dewy, which is really nice. On the other side, let's try the By Terry Brightening CC Serum. Hydration, radiance, color correction. This does smell really heavily of roses, but looking at that side of my face now, it is kind of drying out a little bit. I don't know why on earth you would apply this after foundation. It would serve no purpose as compared to applying it before. I don't see why they would write that. Feel free to correct me if I am wrong, because it's happened before many times. Like that Charlotte Tilbury foundation primer thing that I thought was a foundation and I was like, oh, this is terrible, there's no coverage. Not realizing that it wasn't actually a foundation, it was indeed a primer, so. Okay, the next product I'm really excited to use, it's the new Benefit Hello Happy Soft Blur Foundation. And I've got a couple shades here. I think I'm gonna be, ooh, that's quite light. I'll do a little swatch test. This one looks a little bit too light. I mean, I am quite fair at the moment, but I don't want to look ghostly. So it's the Sheer to Medium Coverage Liquid Foundation SPF 15. Cute little package. Soft Blur Foundation looks like skin and feels like nothing at all, which is right up my alley these days. Oh, cute, little lid's pink. To use, shake well before use. Blend one drop onto clean, moisturized face. Repeat to build coverage. Hello Happy Makeup Sponge. I have wet mine, so it's like huge. It's really soft, really nice. I'm going to apply it with the sponge on one side and then apply it with a brush. Sorry, I'm trying to adjust myself on the other side. Ooh, interesting. It's like pure water. Oh, what shade am I even using? I'm using two. I feel like this beauty blender is going to eat up everything, because that's why I don't tend to use beauty blenders in the first place, because they absorb everything. Like, I can't even tell that I've applied that. I've got 3 drops on the back of my hand. 3 kilogram drops. Ooh. Okay, so far, I can't actually tell if it's on my face. I can't tell. I'm like assuming that it is on my face. And it's meant to be like a light coverage. With that being said, I'm not sure if it's actually amazing because I can't see it on my skin. I just don't actually know. I can't judge because if it's on my skin, then that looks amazing because I can't tell that it's on there. It looks super, super natural. Okay, it's definitely on my face. I'm looking in the viewfinder now and you can see that this side is less red than this side. So there's definitely something there, which is cool. It means that it's really, really super natural. Okay, I'm going to go in with a brush now because we all know I prefer them anyway. Ugh, yes. So much better. I have noticed that on this side of my face, it seems to be the foundation is clinging to my pores more than on this side. But to be fair, I could see the primer clinging to my pores beforehand, so it could just be the primer. I think I'm actually preferring the side with the sponge. I feel like I wouldn't use either of those primers again, to be honest. I feel like this foundation definitely needs a really hydrated base. Actually, I'm really keen to try these. It's a really weird product. It's by Hourglass. It's their Veil Retouching Fluid. So essentially what I think it is, I've lost the little PR parcel handout thing. What I remember it saying was something along the lines of, you bring it in your bag because it's obviously quite a small little tube compared to a normal foundation. And then you use it to touch up your foundation if it comes off during the day. So it's like a touch up foundation, hence the small size. So it's kind of hard to try that out when your foundation's been freshly applied because it hasn't run out. So it's been weird for me to, I haven't even had a chance to actually give it a go. But now that my foundation, it could use some like evening out and whatever, I'm going to try one of these. Okay, it has a little doe foot applicator. I don't know how you apply this, but I'm just gonna, okay. This may look like crap because I'm using it over other products. Wait, but it's meant to be used over other products. It's a little bit lighter, which I'm not angry about because I'd rather it be lighter at this stage. Another product where I'm like, I don't know if I'm missing something. I feel like I'm missing something. I love the idea of it. I love the idea of it. But then I also think like what is the difference between this and like a concealer? Like why wouldn't you just use a concealer? Maybe it's better to be used with actual Hourglass products maybe, because I'd apply it there and there's no difference. Before I powder, I'm going to apply some blush. This is the Shiseido Minimalist Whipped Powder Blush. That is what it looks like. I believe it's their new cosmetics range. Cream blushes really intimidate me. I feel like it's so easy to go overboard instantly. It literally feels, that's so cool. Very whipped. My issue with cream products is that I feel like when you're applying them, if they take off foundation as they're applied. Some of them don't. This one's not doing it. Damn, my under eye powder's upstairs. Okay, in that case, I'm just gonna set my, I don't even really need to really. I have like no moisture left on my face as it is. But just to set these areas that crease. The By Terry Hyaluronic Hydra Powder. Colorless Hydra Care Powder. Extra smoothing multi-zones correction. No pores, no lines. Matte invisible finish. Oh, it's just one of these white powders. What are the ingredients? Yeah. They make it sound so hyaluronic hydra powder, colorless hydra care powder, extra smoothing, multi-zones, correction, no pores, no lines, matte invisible finish. And that's all well and good. Like, this would be amazing. I haven't tried it yet, but I was thinking, like, I bet the ingredients are like silica because that's what all of these powders are. And the ingredients, literally, silica, sodium hyaluronate, sodium hyaluronate is obviously the hyaluronic component of the powder. Just sharing my opinions as a consumer, you can get silica powders everywhere for probably a very affordable price too. The only difference is this one has the hyaluronic hydra powder. I personally don't like these powders because they leave a ghostly effect on my skin over the whole face. They just like flash back and they're too matte. But I'm going to give it a go. Okay, so this stupid sun has gone behind the clouds. Finally, my lighting is better. Today is an overcast day, so the sun comes out, then it goes behind. Right now it's behind and you can see my makeup a lot better. The blush looks really nice. The blush is beautiful. It has, like I said, it would faded a lot, so it's kind of blended into my skin and it's just left a really natural finish, and it hasn't removed my makeup, which is great. I guess my issue with this is that it's the same thing as buying makeup from a designer brand. Like, you can buy a t-shirt from, I don't know, Off-White for like $700, and then you can buy the exact same t-shirt just without the branding, or different branding, non-designer branding, for like $30. And that shirt that they're selling for almost $1,000 would have cost them like maximum $20 to make, for sure. Like, I can't see it being any more than that to make. And I get it, like, everyone who buys designer stuff knows that they're paying for the brand name. They're paying for the ability to wear something that's like out of most people's reach. It's like the whole status of it, and that, like, you know, it's the way it makes you feel, maybe. It's just, you're buying into like the brand. You're not spending that much because of the quality. For some items you are, of course. There's some really intricate, beautiful embroidered dresses or whatever that are worth paying more for. But for the really simple things, like a powder that literally has two ingredients. Okay, I'm going to Google the price of this before I keep on talking. So I'm looking at Mecca's website. Mecca is the company that sent me this powder. They are kind of like a Sephora. They house all different makeup brands. And for the 10 gram product, which is this one, it is $88. It's got a 4.4 star rating, and 151 reviews. So that means that it's a good product and people like it, and that's awesome. And that means that they can charge that much for it because people like it, so they're going to pay that much. Same thing with a designer brand. You like the brand, you want to be a part of it, you hear other good things about it, you buy it, you spend that extra money because you feel like it's worth it. And for these people, it is. My point with this rant is that there are some things that you don't need to spend the money on. I'm not saying this is a bad product. I have not used it. According to the reviews, everyone seems to love it. That's awesome. Like, 4.4 stars out of 151 is crazy good. That's so good. So obviously people like it. But I'm saying, if you don't have the budget to buy something like this, to spend $88 on something, there are so many other brands you can find that may not have the hyaluronic acid or hyaluronic stuff in it, but will still give you the almost what, pretty much, I'm assuming, the exact same result. I just don't want people to get caught up in the, oh no, like, I have to spend the extra money to get something that's better quality. Like, no. A lot of the time you can get something that's like even better quality for like a quarter of the price. And I'm sure everyone is aware of that these days. Like, you guys are smart. Back in the day, people may not have been aware of that, but these days, shoppers are like really savvy. Whoa, that was a long rant. Cool. I got this new Natasha Denona Super Glow Highlighter. This is in the shade 02 Light Medium. And then on the other side of my face, I'm going to try two different highlighters. This one by Ofra, the highlighter in Star Island. I'll start out with this one first. This one looks really nice because it is quite a light highlighter, and whoa. As you can, ooh. That was weird. I got some like glittery chunks. Are there glittery chunks in there? There's just no moisture in my face. I think that's why I'm like just not feeling anything, because my face, my base doesn't look right because there's no moisture in my face. Anyway, sorry if this feels negative, but I'd rather be honest with you guys and say when I don't like something rather than try and be like, oh, I love it. Yeah, even though you know that it looks bad. So I feel like if you're not honest, people can tell and they're like, oh, you're being fake. But then if you are honest, people are like, oh, you didn't try it. Like, you didn't give it a proper go, or, oh, you're just being negative. So this is the Natasha Denona one now. I was a little worried that it was going to be too dark, but whoa, that's intense. I love it. And this Natasha Denona one can be built up. Can you see that? They're actually very similar colors, but I prefer the Natasha Denona one. This one here. I have this little package from Essence. Brow pencils and Make Me Brow Eyebrow Gel Mascara. 04 Blonde. This one is Soft Blonde. Let's go with Soft Blonde because it looks more grey. This colour's not dark enough, so I'm going to go up to the next one. It's nothing to do with the pencil. The pencil was great. It's fine. Yeah, don't like my shape that I created, which is my own fault. I'm going to try and go over with this Essence Make Me Brow Gel Mascara afterwards. Oh, this is nice. This is really nice. This one was like really, really evenly deposited the product. It's not shiny or glossy because I don't want my brows to look shiny or glossy. It's their Aura Dew Face Eyes Lips Solar 02. Oh, this is nice. Oh, it's nice though. Despite that little hiccup. It actually does look like it's dewy. Like it makes your skin look like it's glossy. This one is the Archliner Ink liquid eyeliner in Shibui Black 01. Sorry, I know I mispronounced that. But look how fine the little nib thing is. And it's on a bit of an angle. When I opened that, I actually physically went, ooh, like cool. So I want to try that on one eye. And then on the other eye, I'm going to use the Quick Flick felt tip eyeliner pen. So you've probably seen this on Instagram. What it is an eyeliner pen that has, you can't really see, I'll put it back in my hand, a stamp on the back. And the stamp is a wing. So there are three different sizes, I think, and this is the largest one. So you stamp the stamp, you've got two pens, like one for your left eye and right eye. So then you use that side to create the wing, and then on this side, you've got an actual normal eyeliner, which you can use to connect the wing to the rest of your makeup. My issue is that I can't always get them in the same, like one of them's always a little higher than the other, or this or that, or I don't know. And I've got quite a defined crease, so I don't want it to like not stamp properly because of my crease. That was my concern, is that I'm gonna like, because my crease is so creasy, it would miss a bit, but that's fine because I can go in with the other side and fill it in. Okay, so I've done like my main wing, but I need to finesse it a little bit more. Like this bit on the side, it's a little bit rough. I need to slightly even it out a little bit more, but I know that if I do that, I'm gonna regret it. But I still need to do it because I'm a perfectionist and I can't let it just sit there. Just like that, just ever so slightly. I could probably make it even more flicky, but that's good enough for me. Oh my God, I did it. I evened it up without butchering it. Oh, it's a great day, it's a great day. I need to like raise my eyebrows to properly show that I've done a decent job. Because I'm gonna go like this, my normal, because my eyebrows, my face is kind of, gravity is taking hold and everything's slightly moving down a little bit. Keep my brows raised to show. From this angle, it looks like it's droopy, but from that angle, it's like super. Okay, now my issue comes with matching that. This one, I'm going to create a fine wing, even though it's not gonna match. I just wanna see what it does. Okay, I think it's almost too fine. No, not a fan. You'd think this would make it so easy to create a fine wing, but no. It's just too short. I feel like if you're gonna have a nice little fine nib, it needs to have more length on it so it can bend with your eye and like move to the contours of your eye. Because this is so stubby and short, it doesn't bend at all. So you're just like, you have to be really aware of the depths and heights of your skin and your face and then move the pen accordingly. Whereas if it was longer and more flexible, it could move with the contours on its own.
Does that make sense? I don't know if that makes sense.
It was 10 times easier for me to create that wing than it has been for me to create this one. And even like that pointy bit at the end of the wing, way easier with this one. And this one's like thick and chunky. This one's tiny and fine. You'd think this one would be like easier to create that fine little touch with, but it's not. It is what it is. Next, I'm going to apply mascara. This is the Hourglass Caution Extreme Lash Mascara. It's very like heavy, luxurious feeling packaging, which Hourglass generally is. So I'm currently brushing out my lashes because it's getting a bit clumpy. I think because I know how much went wrong and how many little things I had to fix, or just, I think because I was annoyed pretty much the whole time at little things that were going wrong, I just had like a bad taste in my mouth about this makeup look. So it doesn't look bad, it's fine, it looks nice enough, but it just, I'm not a fan of it. Oh well, at least it provides like a different kind of first impressions. Normally they're relatively positive and like, oh, this is nice, oh, love this. So this one is like a nice contrast to those ones. I guess that's the silver lining here. Anyway, thank you all so much for watching. I love you guys and I hope to see you all in my next video. Bye.